Local government leaders in the central region, including the NRM chairpersons, mayors, among other government officials, have been undergoing a retreat at Changkwanzi Leadership Institute, which was mainly focusing at reminding them of their duties when it comes to service delivery to the people at the grassroots levels, but most importantly also ensure the implementation of the ruling NRM party manifesto for the 5 years of 2021 to 2026. Officiating at the closure of this retreat, the Minister for Presidency, Millie Babalanda, emphasized the importance of teamwork in achieving the shared goal of transforming and growing the nation.
And you, senior leaders, after being equipped with the skills and information, you go down and do what is required of you, so that the people down there appreciate the NRM government and afford us another term of office.
Babalanda highlighted the importance of socio-economic transformation, not only on a macro scale, but also at the individual level, stressing that genuine transformation involves both mental and physical changes, and urged leaders to focus on imparting positive change within their communities.
These are your relatives who are still living in total abject poverty. Therefore, as leaders, what are your initiatives? You need to change the mindsets of these people so that they enter the money economy.
The director in charge of the manifesto implementation, Wills Bashasha, urged the leaders to always carry out regular performance assessments and evaluation meetings to ensure effective governance at the grassroots level.
Continue to work together as a team in the offices they serve and also across board as leaders at that level. We'd like to, because we would not want to see people trying to serve their selfish interests or making self-interests at the expense of the service delivery where our citizens are not benefiting.
The Permanent Secretary to the Judiciary, Pius Bijirimana, tasked these leaders to always ensure that cases at the grassroots are well handled by the judicial officers for citizens to get justice.
We are finalizing anti-corruption strategy. This anti-corruption strategy is to help us to address all those loopholes which have been there.
On the part of the judiciary, Bijirimana happily reported that they have registered progress and 85% of the manifesto promises have been achieved.
The first commitment was to do with getting video conferencing facilities. And I have told you that our target was to reach all the high court circuits.
The retreat served as a platform for cross-party engagement and collective commitment to the nation's progress. Story by Jaliet Namoya for the news.